Have you ever read that if you stress your plants out, your plants are going to be more potent? Well, in this video, we're going to get into it. You're here with Mark Vowell at PerfectGardens.com.
Please remember to like, share, and subscribe. We got our $2.99 membership, and we have a VIP if you need a little more one-on-one, link down in the description.
Okay, just want to say thank you so much to Anthony for posting this. Absolutely, this does work. If you stress your plants out, you will get a higher resin production. And we've talked about this on other videos about UVB and UVA light. And really, at the end of the day, guys, just remember, stress will make your plants produce more oil production. You see this a lot if you bring your LED lights too close to your plants, right? You get frost tips or white tips, right? That's all because of stress. There's a number of different hormone products that you can purchase on the market that will actually make the plant think that they are being attacked by bugs so that they can increase the oil production. I have heard of a number of different philosophies and thought processes over the years. I've even had growers tell me that they'll drill their stems right before harvest to stress their plants out. All these things are all correct. You stress your plant out, you will get more oil production because it is a defense mechanism. Although how I stress my plants out, because also obviously I do the same thing, how I do it is actually not by stressing the plant out through the growing process, because I've come to the realization through testing these plants grow after grow that I actually get a higher terpene count or a higher profile on the plant when the plant actually has its full time to mature. Although, like all of you guys know this, if you allow the plant to mature too much, you will end up reducing the quality really through the degradation of the plant. You see it through the crystal production, right? Right in the beginning, the oil starts to grow, and then the tip of it starts to swell up, and then at the end of it, it bursts, right? That is letting the plant over mature. I also do think that people don't realize how long it takes to over mature. I actually really like it to get to a complete amber, because I have noticed how much yield gets reduced when I harvest too early. And I think probably 95 to 98% of the growers out there harvest too early. So my secret is actually during the curing process when I stress my plants out. So the little secret is that I've come to the realization is that whenever plants have water, they're living. And if I have a really good curing room that allows for a full 2 to 3 week cure process where the plant won't completely dry out, where I won't let it go to the point where it becomes a dust. Even if I do allow it to dry a little too much, I have two-way humidipacks that allow for moisture to get reabsorbed into the plant. And if anyone thinks I'm crazy on this, go get a leaf that has dried out and then put it in a cup of water and see what happens to the leaf. The leaf will actually reabsorb and expand back out in some level. So what I mean by this is during the curing process, if I have a really nice controlled environment, and once again, I've talked to you guys about the benefits of nitrogen, how I don't like to pre-trim my plants. I actually like the leaves to cocoon my flower and actually create a protective environment. And I'm actually trying to keep as much moisture, right? That's why I don't like to defoliar, or I don't like to clean out all that foliage. I actually like to keep all that foliage on there, because when I harvest, all that foliage is completely protecting my stuff. And all that foliage has moisture and it has minerals and it has everything the plant needs to keep growing. So after I harvest it, the plant starts to get stressed out and I start to get that extra oil production. I've also maxed out my terpene production because my profile has more time to grow on the plant while going through a higher stress environment, while also curing at the same time. While I've also been able to completely avoid stressing out my plant while growing, because when I stress out my plant during growing, it stops growing. And I don't want to do that, right? I want to max out my return on my investment and max out my quality. And at the end of the day, guys, I completely agree. Stress will increase the resin production. So there is that main oil that we always talk about, the THC, CBD. Although there's that terpene profile, right? That terpene profile is actually telling me if the plant met its fullest potential. I'm always interested in developing healthy growing practices that I can transfer into agriculture, big ag practices specifically. What I love about this industry is that it's developed a test, a very inexpensive test that actually tests the quality, right? And it tests the quality through the terpene profile, my viewpoint and opinion. Terpene profile, a larger terpene profile means the plant was healthier through its entire growing cycle. Yes, you have a higher concentration of oil if you stress it out. Although, just like you and I all know, you get those pins that are 100% THC or, you know, all those guys that are dabbing that. In my viewpoint, you know, it's just a better experience when you have a full terpene profile along with it. You know, I've always considered the THC to be the key that unlocks the high, but the terpene profile is really what guides the experience, the medicine. And for me, because I came out of the military and used this plant really not in a recreational experience. I did use it in a recreational experience, obviously, but more as realizing, wow, you know, it was increasing my well-being of life overall because I was calming down and I was processing my life experiences in a healthier manner than not using this medicine. I've started to care more about treating this plant as a medicine, you know, so that it keeps guiding me down healthy life experiences. I guess my point to all this, guys, is that there's a number of different ways to stress the plant out. I completely agree with you, Anthony. I would recommend, at the end of the day, grow a healthy plant. And through growing a healthy plant without bugs, without having to lose all your foliage, it drying out because of pH issues or PM issues, and you have to defoliate because you don't want the PM, and you end up using hydrogen peroxide, which ends up further drying out your plants quickly. And I've talked about this a number of times about how it just speeds up the oxidation process. Again, once again, if you just grow a healthy plant, you're going to be able to access the full potential of this plant. Please remember to like, share, and subscribe. Have a great grow, everyone.
So, what are mother plants and why are they important in a grow room? Weather plants are specially selected plants that are kept for the purpose of producing cuttings for cloning. Weather plants have many benefits, but there are also some significant disadvantages to consider.